Hi, AT from CNC at home. Recently, there was some work done on my house where they had to do some flashing, and there was a bunch of scrap left around, just this thin, I'm assuming aluminum stuff. It's white on one side, brown on the other. I was curious to see if this would etch in the laser or not. I would imagine that the brown side will. Don't know what parameters would be. And this white should be able to be etched on. So I'm going to take this over to the laser, and using LightBurn, we're going to use their material test program or feature, and we'll run some burn parameters and see what numbers work well on this. If you like this video, think about giving it a thumbs up. Let's head over to the laser and see how that looks. Well, there's really not a whole lot of good data here. Even burning at 6,000 millimeters per minute at 20% power did an okay job. We are losing here at 510 and a little bit on 15. We're starting to not get through. So we have some numbers. So this is very easy to burn through. The next experiment will be to try burning through this brown side, see how that does. And now that I think about it, this was done without focusing the laser. How close are we? Yeah, we're way too high. So even with if the laser had been focused, this would have been even worse or faster, whatever. Anyway, let's get this flipped over and run some more experiments. That gives us lots of burning parameters that should work well. From dark, which we'll probably clean off, I'll rinse this. But even these slow powers at high speed is getting right through this. That was a good test. In setting up the parameters to burn this first test, where we went 35% up to 80%, 1,000 millimeters per minute up to 2,800, every single one of the squares burned through the paint, no problem. I readjusted and did 10% up to 50% at 3,000 millimeters per minute up to 6,000, which is just smoking fast. And we finally got some parameters that worked and didn't work. You can see here at 10% power, actually it started at 5%. Sorry, it actually started at 5%, which never burned through. 10% just kind of did a little bit here and then faded off quickly. 15 faded off. So we got some good burn parameters where we can go fast and get this burned nicely. Basically here at about somewhere between 4667 and 5,000 millimeters per minute at 50% power. So we can go fast and get through the material. So this will work well if I want to make some signs or just little tags or something. On the back side of this, where it's brown, we got some really good results here as well. Interesting results too. 25% power up to 70% power, and 1,000 millimeters per minute all the way up to 3,800 millimeters per minute. This whole area up here burned through no problem, even at the low power of 25. What's interesting is at the slow speeds, with the higher power setting, it turned darker.
So something is happening with this coating that kind of turned black and dark on here. I have washed this off and this part remained down here. What I'd like to do is get this under the microscope and just kind of zoom in on this area to see if we can see what's happening with that. So let's get this under the microscope and take a look.
Zooming in on this 70% power at 1,000 millimeters per minute, we can see kind of that something's happening here. It's dark. It's not the aluminum color underneath. My assumption is that the coating is getting melted and with the extra power ends up just sticking on here. If we look at the 1,000 millimeters per minute at 25% power, we zoom in, we see more reflective aluminum and less of the dark black stuff. So something about keeping the power on. If we go up to the 3600 at 25% power, we can see virtually all of it is just the aluminum with a little bit of residue left behind. So that's what it looks like close up.
Those were some interesting results. I'm glad we did this test. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Also, if you like the content of our channel, think about subscribing. It really helps us out. Enjoy doing your CNC at home projects and stay curious.
Oops.
Lights out.